Hey guys, how you doing? This is Tony Karamitsos, Diecast Brand Manager here at Round 2. Today we're going to be flipping the script and I'm going to introduce you Chad Reid, who's going to be talking about his race car. All right guys, I'd like to introduce you Chad Reid.
How's it going everyone?
All right Chad, show us what's going on here. You brought this beautiful race car that you have.
Oh yeah, gorgeous.
So I'm going to pan to the car, I'm going to have you walk around and I'm going to ask you some questions and just fill us in what you have going on here.
Okay, all right.
All right. Well, here you go, guys. Here's Chad's awesome ride, his race car here. All right, Chad, why don't you fill us in what's going on? What's the story behind this thing? You know, I know you got a race that's coming up and what was the, you know, purpose behind this build?
So this is a pretty ridiculous build. Me and some friends went in on this and it's for a endurance race that you guys may know about called 24 Hours of Lemons. So the point of that is you need to buy a car and do any performance modifications. You only got a $500 budget. So they want you to have the most ridiculous theme, the most ridiculous paint job, home-brewed kind of modifications done to it. So this was a car that was listed for sale for $350. It's a 1998 Honda Civic DX hatchback with a 5-speed manual. So the point of this, our ridiculous theme, is Trailer Queen. If you've heard of Trailer Queens, like cars that normally go to the track or go to shows. So this is more like the beautiful girl that you might see at the trailer park kind of Trailer Queen. So the paint job is, think of Peg Bundy as a car. So we went with the leopard print paint job. We went with the glittery purple on the car, and every modification, performance-wise, has to stay within that $500 budget. So you pick a car up for $350, you don't have a lot to work with. So basically what we did is bought some really cheap coilover suspension for it, did a lot of home-brewed stuff, did the paint job with spray paint in the driveway, cut some vents into the hood with a grinder. And the whole point of this race is it's not necessarily who's the fastest. You have 2 days to run. And it's who can put in the most laps, so reliability is a key. So Honda's actually a pretty good car, despite the fact that it is incredibly slow. But there are a few obvious differences to the rule, to the $500 rule. They want you to be safe, so you're allowed to have nice tires. These tires are actually more than the rest of the car was. Tires are exempt from the budget. Brakes are exempt from the budget, so we did Hawk pads and some nicer brakes so it's not wearing out during the race. And then obviously they want you to be safe, so
I was gonna say, show us what you have going on in here, what kind of safety features and other modification that you guys have done. Looks like you've taken out some weight, got a nice roll cage in here. Yeah. And a fire suppression system, but what else you got going on?
Yeah, it's fully gutted on the inside. So part of the regulations for Lemons, because you are racing wheel to wheel with like 80 to 100 other vehicles. So a roll cage is necessary for the car. So we had the car sent up, had a full roll cage put in it. That was all up to 24 Hours of Lemons regulations. So along with that, you have to do a roll cage. You have to do a 5 or 6 point harness. A full racing seat. We did the removable steering wheel just to make it easier to get in and out, because you are on a team of usually 4 to 6 drivers that'll be switching during the race in and out, and just trying to get people as quickly into the car and back out onto the racetrack as you can. The other thing that they make you do is a fire suppression system. So we've got a 5-pound fire extinguisher that's all plumbed up. It'll shoot foam onto the driver's feet, and also it goes into the engine bay in case there's any sort of fires on the racetrack. So this is a very cheap car with a lot of safety equipment in it, just so we can get out there and go wheel to wheel and really get some seat time in it. So there's some other things we did. Made some door cards out of scrap metal. You know, everything's obviously spray painted. Kill switch added in case they have to come and kill the car if there's a wreck or something like that. So we tried to keep kind of the gold and purple theme throughout as much as we can. So anything This car has not been ran yet, so our first race is June 29th at Gingerman Raceway, which is up in South Haven. It's about an hour away from round two here, so I'm doing pit duty for the first race. A lot of the guys that went in with me on this car are going to be running it, and hopefully I'll be running around October at the second race there if everything goes well. So if anybody's around in the area and wants to spectate, you can check out Lemons 24hoursoflemons.com and see what they do. So besides that, I mean, it's just a ridiculous fun car, the cheapest way you can do wheel to wheel, and just a goofy driveway paint job.
Yeah, I love what you've done with it. You guys have done a tremendous amount of work, and actually in a real short time. You know, that's
This car, we bought it for an autocross when we were in the UP. We just found it on Craigslist really cheap and decided we wanted something to run in an autocross that weekend. And this March, we kind of sent it up and got serious about doing Lemons and got the roll cage in it. So everything else, this car was stock in March, and everything else has been done since then to get to this race this weekend, or next weekend. So we are excited. We're hoping that everything went well. Taking it to work was the first kind of run on the road with a lot of the parts we did. We had to change fuel lines and do some subframe work and some other stuff just to make it a safe car.
Yeah, I love the decorations, all the paint work that you guys did, and you know, just all the suspension you can see that's been done underneath too, and
you know,
different exhaust. I mean, on a budget, and you know, it's a lot of work, you know. But glad to see that you guys are doing this on a budget. And how many cars are going to be at this event?
Well, I have to check the registration for it. I know I have friends who had run in Lemons before, and there were about 80 some cars on track, and that year only about 40 of them finished. So we're hoping it'll be a little more this year, but it's going to be busy. Gingerman is a pretty big event, so we are really excited about it. It's going to be crowded for sure, and it's a full-on. You go for 14 and a half hours, so Saturday you go from 10 to 7, and then you go from noon to 5 on Sunday. So this car's going to get a lot of miles on it, a lot of hard miles on it. So excited to see if we blow it up.
Well, hopefully you don't, and hopefully you guys do really well, especially for your first time out. I'm sure you guys will. But, you know, good luck to you guys. We wish you guys all the best. You know, when you see a giant lightning sticker and some Auto World stickers on there as well, we'll get you set up with those. But anything else you want to add, Chad?
Well, I just want to let everybody know that, you know, if you want to poke Tony and tell him that Johnny Lightning has this casting and you want to see the car, I mean, he's the guy to bother. So otherwise, let us know what you think in the comments. If you think it's a ridiculous Honda with a bunch of cheap parts, that's cool too. If you think it's cool for some driveway paint job and just beating stuff around, we want to hear about it. So we'll see you guys around. We'll do some more round two rides videos, and there's a lot of other cool stuff to show you.
All right. Well, thanks, Chad. Appreciate it. All right, guys. We're signing off until the next time. Chad, once again, good luck. And who knows? Maybe you'll see this in one of our Street Freaks programs. All right. Take care.